हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट ए टॉपिक, न्यू टॉपिक। बिफोर वी स्टार्ट, वी विल आल्सो लर्न व्हाट इज कॉल्ड सोलेनोइड एंड देन वी विल लर्न दैट व्हाट इज द मैग्नेटिक फील्ड प्रोड्यूस्ड बाय द सोलेनोइड एट इट्स एक्सिस एंड अबाउट दैट रीजन। हियर यू सी, बिफोर वी स्टार्ट वी मस्ट लर्न व्हाट इज सोलेनोइड। Solenoid is a coil made from insulated wire. A helical like a structure, a spring like a structure, and having the wire insulated so that when they come in contact with each other, say for example you wind up a wire over this pen, what will happen? The structure obtained will be called solenoid, provided the wire used is insulated in nature. Means if the two wires, neighboring wires, are connecting each other, are getting in touch with each other, no current is transferred directly through it, then that's structure. You can see we have a coil like structure. The wire is assumed to be insulated, then that coil is known as a solenoid. It has it carries some current through it, and once the current starts flowing through the coil, you can understand there has to be some magnetic field produced. So we are going to find the magnetic field produced due to the solenoid which carries some current I. We have also assumed that the length of the solenoid is large, much larger as compared to its radius. Means say for example this is the diameter totals, this is the diameter, the thickness of the pen, and you see half of that will be the radius. We have marked it as 2R. And then if this radius, say for example we have approximately 7 millimeters radius here, and the length of the solenoid is much larger, say few meters, then we can say that it is a long solenoid. And then for we are talking about this long solenoid means the length of the solenoid is much greater than the radius of the solenoid. According to Ampere circuit law, we will find this integral, line integral of B dot dl is mu zero I. We already know from this law, so we take it like this. Now we consider an Ampere loop ABCDA such that the arm AD and BC are infinitely long. Why we are choosing it? I told you earlier that this Ampere loop is giving us the freedom. Whatever loop, whatever the dimension, whatever the size, whatever the shape of the loop, you can choose for your convenience. So why we are choosing it? So that the magnetic field at the arm CD can be taken as zero. Because if the distance is infinitely large, then then the magnetic field is supposed to be diminished to be zero. And here from the figure we can find the line integral of B dot dl is equal to integration over the arm AB plus arm BC plus arm DC and plus arm DA. So we have these four steps integration for the different arms. Now for the first case, for arm AB, the magnetic field and the dl element will be along the arm AB. So magnetic field and dl element, loop element dl, will be parallel, and therefore the integral for AB, integral B dot dl for AB will be B into integration of dl, and total length of the loop will be equal to the length of the loop AB, that is L. So you see magnetic field is, we are taking it out because we take it as constant, and then we get B dot dl integration for arm AB is equal to BL. Now for arm BC and AD, for arm BC and AD you see, the magnetic field be always perpendicular to these arms BC and DA, and therefore they are having 90 degree relationship, therefore their dot product becomes zero. So the integration for arm BC and arm DA, these two becomes zero. Now we are left with arm CD. Since the arm CD is taken to be very large, at very large distance, infinitely large distance, therefore the magnetic field at that location CD will be zero. And once the magnetic field is zero, B dot DL will become zero. So that means out of all four integrations, only the first one survives equals to BL, and therefore we get integration B dot DL is equal to BL, where L is the length of the solenoid. Now equating equation 1 and equation 2, we get magnetic field at the center of the solenoid is equal to mu 0 I by L. But here we have considered I current is enclosed by the loop. But that is not true. Here you see, if you look at the loop, you have so many turns enclosed by the loop. So each turn is carrying I current, and therefore if there are n turns per unit length, n turns are per unit length is existing for the solenoid. So we have the total current enclosed by the loop will be NL into I. Because for one turn, a current enclosed is I. For two turns, it should be 2I. So if there are N turns per unit length and the total length is capital L, then that means N turns is for unit length, and if the length is L, say for it example it is 2, then 2 into N should be there. That means 2 into L, that is NL, and multiplied by the current, each arm, each wire is supplying I current, so total current enclosed will be NLI, and that divided by L, you see one we got mu 0 I by L. And for I, we are replacing it by NLI. Therefore, what happens? L in numerator is cancelled by denominator, so we get magnetic field at the center of the solenoid is mu 0 NI. And the magnetic field at the axis and about the axis of the solenoid is therefore uniform, because you see it is not depending on anything else except the number of turns per unit length for a given solenoid, it is constant, and the current flowing through the wire, and that can be also maintained constant. So once I is constant, N is already constant, so we get magnetic field at the center and about the axis uniform, means same. So this is a big source of giving us a uniform magnetic field, but nature do not give us uniform magnetic field. We will discuss it in coming chapters, that how the natural magnets are not able to provide uniform magnetic field to this extent as the solenoids can is providing us. Now one thing more remarkable we have to discuss is that we have considered that the magnetic field is, we are talking about the magnetic field inside, well, deep inside the solenoid, and the center or something deep inside the solenoid we have calculated. But if you consider to find the magnetic field at the end points of the solenoid, means at the end part of the solenoid, say for example over here, then it should be half only. Half of the magnetic field at the center. Well, why this happens? This you can consider, say for example we have one loop, and each loop is having some magnetic field. We have already calculated that magnetic field due to a loop, we have found it. So magnetic field due to a loop is there along the axis and in a particular direction, it is having particular magnitude, that is fixed. Now each loop is contributing in same sense. So say for example we have so many turns and we want to find the magnetic field over here. So the coil on the left of it also contributes in the same sense, and coil on the right of it also contributes in the same sense. So they together contribute at the center to make it something which is called B center. Now if we talk about the magnetic field at one end, what happens? The contribution of the first part of the solenoid is there, but as we move away from the point considered, what happens? Their contribution becomes poor, and therefore we can understand that only half of the solenoid is contributing to the magnetic field and remaining half is not appreciably contributing to the magnetic field at the end point, and therefore it becomes half of that at the center of the solenoid. Thank you and have a nice day.